Members of the esteemed media, we would now like to open the floor for Q&A. We have mics in the audience. Kindly raise your hands if you'd like to ask a question. We'll pass on the mic to you.
I'd like to applaud you for that. I think since Le Bhari, I think you brought one flavor to regional cinema that was a slightly commercial flavor that I think everybody thought when it comes to regional, you all had your own judgments about how regional cinema is and how they are. But you could actually prove that you could also make a blockbuster and it could be a big movie. Do you think that is encouraging in its own self? People now want to venture more into Marathi cinema also because you find it very profitable, that it is very commercial and it can become big budget.
First of all, I would like to say that, yes, you know, we did attempt something different when we were doing Le Bhari. When Nishikant and we got together, we thought, let's try and make an action drama in Marathi on the lines of how probably South Indian films used to happen. Such a genre probably was rarely attempted in Marathi, and it was one of the kinds, and we were at a risk. We didn't know whether such a film would be accepted. Because also, Le Bhari kind of movies had there were a lot of releases in Hindi, and eventually Marathi audiences are the same audience that watch Hindi movies, so it's not something new to them. But yes, in their own language, in Marathi language, it was one of the first movies, and I'm glad that it did well. The beauty of Marathi cinema is the fact that it's done in a limited budget. Today, Hindi films are burdened by the kind of money that you have to spend on publicity, the kind of competition you have within two films, three films that are releasing, and that really increase the kind of money that you spend on a film, and the total cost of the film really goes up high. But thankfully, in Marathi, that's not the case. We have reduced the promotional days to say 15, 14 days, 2 week, 3 week promotion maximum. And hence that doesn't burden the movie too much. And eventually we hope that in a smaller budget, even if you make like a film in a 2.5-3 crores and you spend 1.5 crore, so you have just 5 crores to recover with a great satellite, you can still manage that kind of fund. So yes, I think content is something that is prime most important. It's not necessary that films like Le Bhari only would do a certain kind of commerce, but yes, we have seen in recent past that films like Fandry have done really well. Films like Palak Palak, which is not like a Le Bhari film, has done well. Time Pass, Part 1, Part 2, smaller budget films have done as much business as Le Bhari. So I'm glad that people are putting the money more on content. And I think that's what should be in every industry right now.
No, absolutely. And also, do you think the involvement of so many big stars from Bollywood who are trying to, who have their own production houses, you know, Akshay apparently wanted to make another Marathi film, and a lot of them, you know, you wanted Salman for a cameo. When names like this also get associated, you know, the focus on regional cinema also increases. I think, you know, there was a time when, you know, the focus was not that.
I think films that have done recently well that have probably won at the national level, national awards, once the film does well within the trade instantly knows about it, and within the industry, you know, it spreads like wildfire. You know that, oh, there's a certain Marathi film that is done well, there's a certain Punjabi film that is done well. So I'm glad that people from established production houses, be it stars themselves or production houses, like Eros, Viacom, are venturing into Marathi film, but that's really great, you know. And I think India is not about only Hindi cinema. It's about cinema across and in various languages. And I really feel that it's important for all of us to make sure that we nurture regional cinema and not let it die.
Namaskar, sir. Ritesh Saranna.
नमस्कार
इकड़े इकड़े
नमस्कार
जितेश सर का एक्चुअली प्रश्न है सर आपसे जानना चाहेंगे कि एक्चुअली आप जो अवार्ड्स इस साल दे रहे हैं वो 2014 के जो फिल्म्स हैं उनको दे 2015 एक्चुअल खत्म नहीं हुआ इसलिए आपने 2014 को कंसिडर किया होगा दैट इज अ वन थिंग लेकिन क्यों यही एक रीजन है या उसके पीछे ये जस्ट स्टार्ट हो रहा है अगले साल से उस साल के जो फिल्म्स होंगे मराठी उसको आप देंगे आणि रितेश तुला प्रश्न असा आहे की ऑलरेडी अनेक अवॉर्ड्स जे आहेत ते आत्ता मराठीमध्ये वेगवेगळी जे अवॉर्ड्स फंक्शन्स होतात म्हणजे मिक्टा आहे मिफ्टा आहे ही वेगवेगळ्या ठिकाणी आता आहे त्यांनी एक स्वतःचे मार्क्स ऑलरेडी एस्टॅब्लिश केले अशात तुला एक कलाकार म्हणून फिल्मफेअरचं वेगळेपण काय वाटतं की फिल्मफेअरचं सगळ्या अवॉर्ड्समध्ये जिथे सर तुमच्यापासून
मी इंग्लिशमध्ये बोललो तर चालेल ना
मराठीत बोललात तर जास्त
जी मराठी खरंच फार छान आहे
मग बोलू
But you know, I'm very nervous while speaking to you on these matters. So initially, we take the theatrical releases from Jan 1st to December 31st. Unfortunately, this year it's been so late. But next year we plan to do it much more earlier. So we will be only considering the films of 2014. I know in 2015. A lot of good films have released and all of that, you know, like Court, Killa and all of that. But we will be considering them in the next year. So this year we will be only looking at the films of 2014. Ritesh, you want to go with the next?
I think kasa hai ki Filmfare ek jasa mi suratilas manalo to ki Filmfare ek iconic brand hai. Aani, त्याचं जे असोसिएशन आहे इन टर्म्स ऑफ तुम्ही जेव्हा एखादा चित्रपट पाहता तुम्हाला आवडतो आणि नंतर त्याचा शो होतो टी व्हीवर तीन तुमच्या फेवरेट ॲक्टरला जेव्हा अवॉर्ड मिळतं तेव्हा त्याचा आनंद आणि असं जर म्हणालं की जर फिल्मफेअर नंबर वन अवॉर्ड आहे भारतात तर हे काही चुकीचं ठरणार नाही आणि जर हीच प्रतिमा हीच मूर्ती हेच अवॉर्ड एखाद्या मराठी ॲक्टरच्या हातात असेल आणि एखाद्या मराठी चित्रपटाचं ते जर मिळत असेल तर त्याचं स्वागतच आहे मला वाटतं की लोक आतुरतेने वाट पाहतात या अवॉर्डची
जितेश सर एक फक्त तुम्हाला त्यात प्रश्न विचारायचा तो असा आहे जितेशजी तुमच्यासाठी की फिल्मफेअर अवॉर्ड्स यापूर्वी पण जी होत होती त्याच्यामध्ये देखील मराठीसाठी एक स्पेशल कॅटेगरी असायची की डिरेक्टर्स असतील किंवा ॲक्टर्सना अवॉर्ड्स दिले जायचे अशात तुम्हाला असं का वाटलं की संपूर्णपणे एक वेगळं अवॉर्ड मराठी कंप्लीट इंडस्ट्रीसाठी वेगळं सुरू करावं
बिकॉज लाईक आय फील इन द लास्ट 5 years मराठी सिनेमा इज रिअली कम ऑफ एज अँड इट्स टाईम दॅट वी अक्नॉलेज द टेक्निशियन्स अँड द ग्रेट टॅलेंट आय मीन एव्हरी फिल्म आय हॅव बीन वॉचिंग सो मेनी फिल्म्स आय हॅव बीन वॉचिंग लाईक जस्ट येस्टरडे आय वॉच्ड आय थिंक 1000ची नोट अँड आय थिंक इट वॉज फँड्री so you know I'm just blown every day by seeing so many you know films and I think it's important to recognize the work of all the technicians who have contributed and more importantly the actors